guys, it's Pastor Breanna, and this is our last memory verse station together, which is super sad, but I thought, let's make it a good one. I mean, they've all been good, but I figured today we would learn one of my favorite verses in the whole entire Bible. That is Romans chapter 12, verse 1. It is a verse that talks about how we go out and we serve God. We learned yesterday about how we can change. Today we've been talking about how we can do something. And so I thought Romans 12 verse 1 was an excellent verse to help us remember that. But before we get into our Bible verse for today, we are going to talk a little bit about what it means to go out and serve God. Now Jesus said, suppose one of you has 100 sheep. That's a lot of sheep. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. A lot of sheep. And out of that 100, he loses one. Won't he go and look for that lost sheep until he finds it? When he finds it, he will joyfully put it on his shoulders and bring it home. Then he will call his friends and his neighbors and say, rejoice with me, be joyful, I have found my lost sheep. Wow, Jesus talked about sheep in this story, but who was Jesus really talking about? Yeah, Jesus was talking about all of us. We are his sheep. And this story shows us how important each one of us is to God. Nothing will stop him from coming after us and finding us. He loves us that much. You can be brave and confident because you know that God loves you. Because you know that he made you for a reason. And he would do anything to find you. I'm gonna say that again because it's just so important. God loves you, and he would do anything in the whole entire world to find you. He loves you, and because he loves you, you can make a difference. So let's remember today's big idea. I can have confidence to make a difference. So let's get into that memory verse I was telling you guys about a little bit earlier. It's Romans chapter 12, verse 1, and it says this. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as living sacrifices, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. Now, we've used very similar methods of learning verses this week, but there's tons of other ways you can learn verses. Sometimes I like to make actions for them. Sometimes I like to act them out and do skits. Sometimes I'll write all of the words down on a piece of paper and I'll cut it up and then I'll use it like a puzzle to try and put the words back together. But one of my favorite ways to learn memory verses is by making songs or raps. And so I was looking up songs for Romans 12 verse 1 and I found one that made me laugh a lot. It's very funny, but it's very effective, and I think I'm gonna have this song stuck in my head all day, which means that I'm going to have this verse stuck in my head all day. So I'm going to play it for you guys now so we can all enjoy it together.
One, two, three. Therefore I urge you, brothers, in view of God's mercy, to offer up your bodies. Offer your bodies. Therefore I urge you, sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer up your bodies. Offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing. As a living sacrifice, as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing. This is your true and proper worship. This is your true and proper worship. This is your true and proper worship. Holy and pleasing to God, this is worship. Row, 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 row. Romans 12 verse 1. Row, 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 row. Romans 12 verse 1. Row, 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 row. Romans 12 verse 1. Holy and pleasing to God, this is worship.
Guys, some of those actions were so good. The violin at the start, one of my favorites. It was a good job. And it's helpful for us to remember verses. Now, I'm going to put the verse up on the screen while we read it together one more time. Romans chapter 12, verse 1. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. All right, so we're going to say this verse, and I'm going to take off the last word. Look at it now, look at it closely, like burn it into your memory because it's going to be disappearing, and you're gonna have to type in the last word for me, okay? Are you guys ready? Romans chapter 12, verse 1. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper. Time for your word. Did you remember your word? I hope so. We're starting off pretty easy with just one word gone. Your word is worship, right? But what if I took off another word? So now you've got to remember proper worship. Are you guys ready? Romans chapter 12, verse 1. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and... What were your two words? Proper worship, right? Good work. All right, I'm going to take off two more words this time. Are you ready? Romans chapter 12, verse 1. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your... I almost forgot how many words you were supposed to say. Four, right? True and proper worship. Good work. All right, I'm gonna take off another phrase this time to see if you remember. I'm gonna make it real tricky for you. So I'm gonna take off the whole part that says holy and... do you think you can do it? That's pretty hard. Okay, let's try it. Holy and pleasing to God. It's like five words gone. Look really closely at the screen. They're gonna be disappearing and it's gonna get super hard. All right, are you ready? Three, two, one. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice. Oh my goodness, guys, so many words to remember. You had to remember, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. Oh, guys, it's getting really hard. What if I take off... I'm going to be nice to you this time because last time was so hard. What if I just take off two words this time? Can you do it with two words gone? The words I'm taking off, in addition to our other, like, 500 words. Not 500, but a lot of words. I'm taking off the words living sacrifice. All right? Let's give it a try. Romans chapter 12, verse 1. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a... Now it's your turn. Wow, guys. You just had to do 14 words. 14, yeah, that's insane. All right, so let's say that end part all together. Living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. Oh my goodness. Are your brains hurting? Are they tired? They have been working hard, but we're going to make them work a little bit harder still. I'm going to take off three. Do you think you could do it if I took off three words this time? So now I'm taking off bodies as a. All right. Romans chapter 12, verse 1. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your... Oh, it's hard mode. Go team. Done. Good work, guys. All right, let's do it together now. Bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, this is your true and proper worship. All right, you guys are, you're more than halfway done at this point. You're doing really good. Let's take off three more words. That's like the whole middle phrase gone then. Do you guys think you can do it? Let's try. You're gonna remember now, your new words are to offer your, all right? That middle phrase is to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice. I'm gonna count us in. We're gonna try it all together. I guess not technically together. We're doing a tag team here. I'll do the first part, you do the second part, okay? Romans chapter 12, verse 1. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, now your turn. Guys, you just had to remember 20 words. That is an insane amount of words. How many words am I doing? Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, I'm doing 7 words. But on the bright side, I'm gonna have a little less and you're gonna have a little more in a minute. Let's do that part that you just typed in together. To offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. All right, guys, what if I gave you, let's see, this is how much I believe in you. I'm going to take 5 words off of me and give them to you. All right? I'm going to take off, in view of God's mercy, off of me. I'm going to pass it over to you. All right? You guys ready? Romans chapter 12, verse 1. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters. Whoa, my part seems super easy now. Your part, pretty long. I even got mixed up with how many fingers or how many words you had to do. But I hope you typed it all in. Type fast. I'm gonna give you 5 more seconds to type the whole rest of this verse. All right. I hope it's all in there. Guys, you have so much to say that I even got confused. That's how much you have to say. Let's say it together and see if you got it all right. In view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. Okay, guys, I'm not gonna lie. I feel like you probably have this verse all down. So I'm going to take away the whole thing. We're going to try and say it together once first, and then I'm gonna let you say it by yourselves. Are you guys ready? All right, let's take it all off the screen. Romans chapter 12, verse 1. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a, oh, I have to think, this is so hard, as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your spiritual, nope, this is your true and proper worship. All right, we did it together. Now I'm gonna let you do it, and then I'm gonna try and do it, and we're gonna see if I got it right. Okay, are you guys ready? I'm gonna give you, how many seconds do you think you need to do this? I'm gonna give you 20 seconds, okay? Are you ready? On your mark, get set, go. You're halfway done. You have 10 seconds left. Okay, guys, time is up. Let's put that verse back on the screen and see if you got it right. Romans chapter 12, verse 1. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. Guys, you did so good. But now it's my turn. I'm a little nervous. You guys set the bar very high. It's tough to follow, but I'm gonna try my best. So let's do this. We'll put it up on the screen for you guys to see, and I'm gonna cover my eyes to see, to make sure that I'm not cheating, okay? So you guys let me know how I did. You ready? Romans chapter 12, verse 1. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. And then this is the part that's the hardest for me. This is your true. Okay, let me think back to the song, the violin. Okay, this is your true and proper worship. Okay, guys, how did I do? Let me know in the chat if I did okay. Let me know how many words I got wrong. I tried my best. Memorizing verses fast is very hard for me, but we all did a super good job together, and I'm super proud of you. Now I'm going to tell you a little bit about why I like this verse so much. This verse is talking about how we don't actually belong to ourselves. We belong to God. God died for us. He paid the penalty for us, and he gives us new life. And so we need to live our lives for him. This verse talks about giving our bodies as a living sacrifice. That means that everything we do, whether it's waking up or brushing our teeth or doing homework or playing piano or playing sports or hanging out with our friends, whatever we do, it all needs to glorify God, because it's all worship. God is always there with us, and we always need to be making sure that our thoughts and our words and our actions and our attitudes are pleasing to him. Today we learned about how we can have confidence to make a difference, and part of that starts with making sure that we are always praising, always giving glory to God, and remembering how much he loves us. So thanks for coming and hanging out with me at Memory Verse Station all week. Guys, we've had a lot of fun. But it is time to pray now, and then go finish up your snack. I'll see you later. Let's pray. Dear God, I thank you so much that you love us. I thank you for the truths that we've gotten to learn this week. I thank you that we've learned that we can have confidence because of how you see us, because how you created us, because of how good you are. And so I ask that you will help each one of us to make sure that we are living our lives as sacrifices to you, that we are always thinking and acting and doing things that would please you. And when we aren't, I thank you that you forgive us, and that we can have confidence to try again and to make a difference. So I pray and ask that you will help each one of us to make a difference in the lives of our family members and our friends and at school. I ask that you will give us courage and strength every single day. I pray this in your name. Amen. All right, guys, I'll see you later. Bye.